Alright, so hi, my name is Joshua King, and I'm 19 years of age, and I am a right wing slash back three player for the Trinidad and Tobago handball national team. I've been playing handball for approximately 4 years now. Getting into handball, I used to observe handball at a development level, I would say, in Presentation College, and from just watching the fellows play, I saw an interest in it, and from that I was invited, and since then I just went with the sport. My favorite handball player will be Luca Barlow. He plays for PSG. He's also a right wing. I idolize him a lot, you know. A lot of his stuff I look at for inspiration because he's great in his position. So I look up to him a lot. I dabble a little bit in basketball, so I'm somewhat of a basketballer. My favorite basketball player would be Carmelo Anthony. I look up to him a lot also. Football, when it comes to football, it would be inevitably Cristiano Ronaldo, the best player in the world. Within my spare time, I do a lot of drawing because I like architecture. I have a desire for it, so I do a lot of drawings on AutoCAD, sketching, just towards that interest. So yeah. So my worst experience with handball was a tournament that we went to in Guadeloupe. That was our introduction tournament, basically. That was the first time, you know, we first exposure to the sport on that level, and we lost. We lost to one of the best teams that was there. That was Martinique at the time. So that feeling was never good. To lose is never a good feeling. But at the same time, it was our first game, our introduction. So, yeah. And when it comes to the best feeling would be playing. I think it would be scoring my first goal for the team. Definitely. Definitely. You know, from receiving the ball, making the dribble, being in the air and shooting. That feeling after and hearing the crowd chant and scream your name, I don't think it's none better than that. So that would be my best experience. Overall, the experience was a good one. It was truly a learning experience, and that is what the entire team, I believe, took away from that Guadeloupe trip. We all learned, we all went, we saw, and we gained experience from it. So it was really, as I said, an introduction, but also a learning experience from the Guadeloupe trip. The favorite memory with the team would be, was in Guadeloupe, I would say, when everyone was together, and it was halftime in a game, and the game was fairly close. And the togetherness I was seeing in the locker room, when we was talking and we was with each other, and the hype that was being created, I think that was a great, great moment to the team. One of the best. Pre-game ritual, definitely. I'm someone who listens to a lot of music, so you could always catch me with the earphones in my ears. So before a game, taking myself psyched up and in that zone to play the match, I would definitely be listening to some music to help turn and, you know, do my best. My training schedule currently, seeing that it's close to competition, is kind of hectic. We train from 3 times for the week, and that is aside personal work. You know, personal work goes every day. Every day, coach always stressing you gotta get all day, putting in hours to get the best results. So it's a full work, I would say. Toughest opponent would definitely be, as I mentioned earlier, would be Martin, because those guys have a lot of experience on us. So going into that game was difficult somewhat mentally and both physically, you know. I would say, yeah, I get at drums, I get at playing the trap set. I enjoy playing the trap set. So I'd say that's a talent I have. As a soup, man. I like soup. Soup would be my favorite meal. Oddly, but soup. I enjoy a good soup. The feeling is definitely a great feeling. Words could barely describe how it feels, especially every time you put on the jersey. You feel like you go out there on a duty to your country, in other words, when you wear the Trinidad flag on your chest, and it's definitely a great feeling. The most serious player on the team, definitely I would say, is Naldo. You know, he always had a serious look about him, and he looked engaged in what he's doing, so he would definitely be the most serious. The funniest player on the team to me would definitely be Therese. Therese is the comic of the team in a sense. You know, he always get in that laughing mood, that cheerful mood. Never no tension when it comes to him. And always a joyous person, so it would be Therese. When it comes to eating the most of the team, definitely I would say that's Isaiah Tate. No hard feelings, Tate, but you know yourself, he's the most of the team. The head coach of the team is Coach Kenwin. He's a man who's very passionate about the sport. He's very engaged in what he does. He sacrifices a lot for the team, both on and off the court, in order for us to master our craft, and you see it every single time we have a training session. My style of play, I would say, as a player who's very unorthodox, I wouldn't do the same thing twice. I would always try to catch you off guard. I have a lot of flair to my playing style. I like to dribble a lot. I like to fit in tight spaces and use my agility in order to score goals. An average day in the life of Joshua King. I'll give him a routine then. Okay, so from start, morning, I had to start my day with a bath. I feel like once you've paid from the start of the day, it really psychs you up for the remainder of the day. If it's a day where I have training, I'll start with a bath, either I'll go and take a morning run, you know, get my blood pumping, get the blood warm, and then throughout that, go and take care of any daily activities I have and be ready for training at 4 o'clock, you know. Then go to training, get training done, come home, a big meal. I always finish the day with a big meal. That's just me. A big meal and a bath to finish the day, and that is basically how it goes. Beach, definitely beach, salt water. I prefer the salt water. It's just a more freeing environment. Yeah, I find a pool more kind of enclosed and a beach more open, so I prefer a beach. So future endeavors, I do definitely see myself playing handball at the professional level in Europe, in a European league, whether it be for PSG or one of the top ranking teams. So currently a couple of members from the team, including myself, are being scouted from scouts from Belgium and Sweden, so definitely we're looking forward to that. When it comes to supporting the team, you all can get the word out there about handball. It's a relatively new sport to the Caribbean, so it could be shared so the development of the sport could occur and the sport could grow. At Instagram, follow at TTO_handball. To follow up on Joshua King, you can follow my Instagram at Joshua_E_King, and you can follow me there.